Il cantiere cipriota Carnic ha una gamma di oltre 20.
The Cypriot Carnic shipyard has a range of over 20 models, and this is the largest of the SL series. And we are going to try it with the maximum motorization allowed by the approval certificate. It is 9.2 meters long and has a width of 296 centimeters. These numbers tell us that it is one of the widest boats in its category. It must therefore have an excellent habitability. We are going to find out. It is laminated with vinyl ester resin, and the structural reinforcements are filled with injected polyurethane foam, so they have also a floating reserve in case of emergency. To design it, I would say that they were inspired by luxury yachts, from which they have drawn, for example, the line of the windows. One of its strengths, common to many Carnic vessels, is the cockpit arrangement, with seats that are transformed many different ways, a versatility that allows you to find the best solution for every occasion. The sofas, as if it weren't enough, they slide on guides. Even the formwork that supports the pilot seats can satisfy different requests. The bridge has two consoles, so here you can arrange your display as large as you want. If there are objects that you want to always have with you, on the boat, as at home, put them in here. I already said that this is a small yacht, and in fact, even for the comfort of the bow sun deck, they were inspired by larger models, and of course, they made it so that this area can also be modified. They have used the sides to get pockets and the bilge to increase the storage volumes. Really designed it well. The seats are contained in fiberglass shells. They are anatomic and have a lumbar backing. Here is the cup holder and underneath the glove box. And then there is the cabin, which is not at all small. At the entrance, the height is 1 meter and 80 centimeters. Down there, towards the bow, look how wide it is. Around the table, there can be at least 5 people, and the bunk is as big as that on a 20 meter. But it is not the only one. There is another, French, under the cockpit. Behind this door, the bathroom. There is also space for a small wet bar, with fridge and cabinets. And to complete the effect, lights and super powerful sound system.
Oggi navigheremo nelle acque vicino a Hyères, nella Francia meridionale. Le condizioni del mare, come al solito.
Today we will sail in the waters of Hyères in southern France. The sea conditions, as usual, are not favorable for a nice day at sea, but they are ideal for a test. We have two 250 horsepower Selva engines, the Blue Whale model, but we know that under those covers there are some Yamaha blocks. They are 3,352 cubic centimeter units, 6 V-cylinders, 24 valves, with phase variation, electronic fuel injection. What more do you want?
Alimentazione a iniezione elettronica. Che volete di più? Le barche come questa, cabinate con tanto spazio sotto coperta per farvi stare comodi per la possibilità.
Boats like this, cabin cruisers with plenty of space under deck to make you comfortable, to give you the chance to stay overnight, usually do not have a hull suitable for these situations, but I could be proven wrong. We begin, as usual, with finding a minimum planing speed. The ascent is good because I have to give a little gas and I already feel that it starts to support itself.
Sento che comincia a sostentarsi.
But in fact, we are at 2500 RPM, 10 knots, and we are already planing. The sky also wants to complicate things and release a few drops of rain. I go against the sea at 3200 RPM, the speed is 18 knots.
18 nodi.
Feel the waves, but I do not suffer. You?
Continuate a stare comodo.
Continue being comfortable on the sofa while I give it a bit of gas.
L'assetto è buono, significa che i pesi sono distribuiti bene.
The ascent is good. It means that the weights are distributed well. I have not touched the trim yet, but it is stretched out over the water, and I'm at 20 knots. Consumption at this cruising pace is 0.45 miles per litre.
Beh, è certo che la potenza non ci manca, eh? 500 cavalli, ma perbacco. In fondo è la potenza di una super.
Well, it is certain the power is not lacking, eh? 500 horses. But wow, it is basically the power of a supercar. Well, we know that boats need more torque and horsepower than cars, but for a boat of this size and weight, about 2.7 tons, without any load, without engines, without liquids, well, maybe you do need to have a little horsepower to make us run faster, even in conditions like these. Its nose rises, but its behavior of the hull serves to soften the entry into the wave. And in fact, I'm sailing at 30 knots, and quite comfortably.
Sto navigando a 30 nodi. E piuttosto confortevolmente. Pioggia, vento, onde,
rain, wind, waves. Well, if you like surfing today, you will surely like this boat in better conditions. Now I give a little bit of trim. I want to raise the bow and push down the throttle.
Oh, gli spruzzi non sono male, eh? Che dite?
The spray is not bad, eh? What do you think? Oh, it's incredible. I can take it to the maximum. Fantastic. In fact, I have to tell you that this has an even better setup and it slams even less. It looks like a racing boat. But is it possible? But it's fantastic. Oh!
Fantastica! Woo!
So, now let's see what speed we reached, because I was very concentrated on driving. I did not trust it, and instead I was wrong, because the boat is safe, and even in fast navigation, even in rough seas. 45 and 7, top speed at 6,000 RPM. Well, not bad.
Non male.
You don't have to supermotorize it like this version, just one big outboard. But certainly, if you have a lot of horsepower on the stern, well, I can tell you that you will enjoy it because it is a cabin cruiser. It is true, but it is also very sporty.